So question number 71 says the value of the definite integral from 0 to 2 root 1 plus u cube plus cube root of u square plus 2u into du is. Very nice question. So let's solve it. Let us say this function is assumed. Let us say fx is equal to cube root of x square plus 2x. Let us say this is equal to y. So we have y cube equal to x square plus 2x, that is y cube plus 1 is equal to x plus 1 whole square, that is y cube plus 1 square root minus 1 is equal to x, right? Now something of this have been formed here, right? Now here it can be seen that f inverse y is equal to square root of y cube plus 1 minus 1. Hence we can say the integral is from 0 to 2 square root of 1 plus u cube, that is 1 plus f inverse u plus, this is f of u into du. This is our required integral. Now here f u is equal to cube root of u square plus 2u, right? Now if we talk about, this is the coordinate axis. Now as f of 0 is equal to 0, also f of 2 is equal to cube root of 4 plus 4, that is equal to 2. So it is 0 at 0, and at 2 the value is 2, right? Let us say f of u is anything like this, right? So f inverse u will be like this. So if we talk about integration of fu from 0 to 2, that is this one. And if we talk about integral of f inverse u from 0 to 2, so this is this area, that is, it is equal to area of this whole rectangle. That is, it is equal to area of this square, which is equal to 4. So we can say this is equal to integral from 0 to 2, 1 into du, plus area of this square, that is 4. So this is equal to 2 plus 4, that is 6. So 6 is our required answer. Next is question number 72, which says let fx be a twice differentiable function defined on minus infinity to infinity such that fx is equal to f of 2 minus x and f dash half is equal to f dash 1 by 4 is equal to 0. Gt is given to us, so we have to find g of 1 plus g dash half plus g dash 3 by 4. So it has been given f of x is equal to f of 2 minus x. So here if we replace x by x plus 1, so we have f of x plus 1 is equal to f of 1 minus x, right? Now differentiating, we get f dash x plus 1 is equal to minus f dash 1 minus x. Now as it is given that f dash half is equal to 0, so putting here x equal to half, we can say this is also equal to f dash half plus 1, that is 3 by 2. Also f dash 1 by 4 is equal to 0. F dash 7 by 4 is also equal to 0, right? Now let's find the value of g1. g1 is equal to integral from minus 1 to 1 f dash 1 plus x square e raised to the power x square into dx. Now applying the property of definite integral, we can replace x by minus x, that is minus 1 plus 1 minus x. So this is f dash of 1 minus x into x square into e raised to the power x square into dx. Now f dash 1 minus x, this is equal to minus f dash x plus 1, right? That is equal to minus of g1. So we can say g of 1 is equal to 0, right? So this is 0. Now we need g dash half. So let's differentiate gt. So we have g dash t equal to f dash 1 plus t into t square into e raised to the power t square. This is g dash t. So we can find g dash of half, that is equal to f dash 1 plus half, that is 3 by 2. into half square into e raised to the power 1 by 4. Now we already know that f dash 3 by 2 is equal to 0. So g dash half is also equal to 0. Now also we have to find g dash 3 by 4. Now we know that f dash of 7 by 4 is also 0. So g dash 3 by 4 is also equal to 0. So our required value is 0. Next is question number 73, which says number of solution for e raised to the power x equal to x cube is. So let us firstly take ln on both sides. So we will get x equal to ln of x cube, or we can say x equal to 3 times ln x. So we have to plot the graph of x by 3 and we have to plot the graph of ln x. And let's see the number of points of intersection. So this is the line y equal to x by 3. Now at x equal to e, at x equal to 1 the value is 0, right? And at x equal to e the value for x by 3 is e by 3, and for ln x the value is 1, right? So 1 is greater than e by 3. So the graph of the function is like this. Right, so the number of points of intersection will be 2. So 2 is our required answer. Next is question number 74, which says if the area of the triangle is 2 square units, then the value of the product of the arithmetic mean of the lengths of the sides of a triangle and harmonic mean of the length of the altitudes of a triangle is. That is, we have to find a plus b plus c by 3 am of the lengths into 3 divided by 1 by h1 plus 1 by h2 plus 1 by h3, where h1, h2, h3 are the altitudes of the triangle. Now we are given the area of the triangle, so we can say area is equal to half into base into altitude. This is equal to delta, that is area, right? Similarly, BH2 is also equal to 2 delta and CH3 is also equal to 2 delta, right? So we can say 1 by H1 is equal to A by 2 delta. Hence, 1 by H1 plus 1 by H2 plus 1 by H3 will be equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2 delta. Therefore, A plus B plus C divided by 3 into 3 upon the value is a plus b plus c divided by 2 delta. So this is cancelled, this is also cancelled. So this is 2 into delta, that is 2. So the correct answer is 4. Now the last one is question number 75, which says we have to find the value of L, that is equal to limit x tending to infinity, cube root of x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3 minus x. Right, now we have to apply here the formula a cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b into a square plus b square plus ab. Here a is equal to cube root of x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3, and b is equal to x. So here L is equal to limit x tending to infinity, we are written a minus b. So a minus b can be written as a cube minus b cube, that is x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3 minus x cube whole divided by a square, that is x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3 raised to the power 2 by 3 plus x square plus a into b, that is x into cube root of x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3. Right? This is the value of L. So L is further equal to limit x tending to infinity. Here x cube will get cancelled with minus x cube. So we are left with x square with some coefficient plus x with some coefficient plus constant term. Let us say c whole divided by x square plus x plus 1, x plus 2 x plus 3 whole raised to the power 2 by 3 plus x into cube root of x plus 1 x plus 2 x plus 3. Now this is further equal to limit x tending to infinity. Now dividing by x square in the numerator and denominator, so we will get this coefficient plus this coefficient upon x plus c upon x square, right? And in the denominator we have 1 plus. Now dividing the second term by x square, it means 1 plus 1 by x, 1 plus 2 by x, 1 plus 3 by x, whole raised to the power 2 by 3 plus. Here dividing by x square, 1x is cancelled and x cubed can be taken inside the square root. So this is again 1 plus 1 by x, 1 plus 2 by x, and here we have 1 plus 3 by x. Now the limit can be applied. So these two will get 0 and we have to find the coefficient of x square. That will be 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is 6 divided by 1 plus. Here we will get 1 plus, and here also we will get 1. So this is equal to 6 by 3, that is equal to 2. So the value of L is 2. So 2 is our required answer. So this was all about AITS 6 for power step. I hope you understood all the concepts. Thanks for watching.